Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker is said to introduce many new revelations in this film that will lead to saga-wide implications by both J.J. Abrams, George Lucas, and even Chris Terrio. This is Mike Zero. Make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel for future Star Wars content. So what's really exciting about Episode 9 is that we also know that this movie is not just going to cater to prequel trilogy continuity, but it's also going to go over into original trilogy content as well. That's going to be used in order to move the characters of Rey and Kylo Ren and others forward from start to finish of this story. Now, what's really exciting about all of this is that these past couple of weeks or so, we've been learning a whole lot more about this film, and when it all comes down to one of the concept art descriptions, this is where things begin to get very intense between both Rey, Kylo Ren, and even an element of Darth Vader. Now, specifically, what's really intriguing about all of this is that a description of a confrontation between both Rey and Kylo Ren on a landing pad, where it's described to take place in front of a series of large explosions caused by Star Destroyers in the background. Rey is said to be holding Darth Vader's melted helmet in front of Kylo Ren, where she is threatening to throw it over the cliff, in which she does as she believes it will lower his temptation toward the dark side. Before Rey throws it over the cliff, it's said that she delivers Kylo Ren new truths about his grandfather Vader that is said to anger Kylo Ren. As the Vader helmet tumbles down to a nearby beach is when Kylo is said to enter a phase of rage and begins to fight Rey that leads to the large lobby of the First Order headquarters, which leads to a scene in which both Kylo Ren and Rey are fighting in front of Darth Vader's charred armor, which eventually is said to catch on fire and set ablaze, giving a parallel to Vader burning in both Episode 3 and Episode 6. Another goes over a moment in which they clash their sabers together, where another flash fight is said to initiate, where they are now fighting in front of both Luke and Vader dueling on Bespin and Cloud City from Empire Strikes Back. It's said to take place in the iconic scene where Vader says, "The Force is with you, young Skywalker." As Rey and Kylo fight up the red glowing steps of Cloud City is where Vader and Luke dueled. It's described that eventually those stairs morph into the stairs within the First Order headquarters when the flash fight ends. So let's go over a couple of parts about this. Now, we do know that Darth Vader's melted helmet is going to have far more screen time in this movie than what it had in The Force Awakens. Basically, J.J. Abrams was setting everything up in Episode 7 as far as Vader in the form of a figurative ghost goes. And that's exactly what will be used, you know, primarily in Episode 9 for Darth Vader, is that, yes, he is going to be a figurative ghost. However, he's also going to be involved in the flash fights. Now, I want to get into that, because a lot of people are expressing their concern about flash fights and whether or not this really is Star Wars-y per se. Now, flash fights, like I've always said, it's a mixture of force bonds, flashbacks, flash forwards, and throwing in a lightsaber duel in the mix, where eventually Rey and Kylo Ren are fighting each other in the actual location in which both Vader and Luke fought, you know, in the whole entire scenery, where we had that moment in Empire Strikes Back, where both Luke and Vader are fighting. That's the same exact location that Rey and Kylo Ren are fighting in, just in front of those red LED steps. Now, what I like about this is that this is giving us a moment in which we finally are able to see exactly how the flash fights are going to evolve. Now, they're literally fighting as both Luke and Vader are fighting in the background. Now, this is all said to be done by redoing the sequence by new unnamed actors that were portraying the roles of Vader and Luke to really make it seamless and seem like it's new, as opposed to using just older footage. Not quite sure how I feel about that just yet, but I guess we'll have to wait and see exactly how it's going to look like on the big screen. So, as far as the other thing goes, where Rey throws the melted helmet of Darth Vader over the edge of a cliff that lands on a beach into the sand, this is where Kylo Ren is said to enter a phase of rage. Now, we heard about this slightly before in the past. However, prior to this happening is that Rey delivers new truths about Kylo Ren's grandfather being Darth Vader, and new truths about that character that Kylo Ren cannot accept, then really makes him very angry, and that's where powerful strikes are made through his lightsaber to Rey's. And that's exactly how the flash fights eventually begin. Now, I want to talk about the Vader charred armor. It's said to serve as one of the props that are used in the background that eventually catches on fire, giving us a direct parallel to what happened to both Vader in Episode 3 and Episode 6. And that's very, you know, poetic, I gotta say. Anakin as Vader on Mustafar burns, and then at the end of episode 6, you know, we had the funeral pyre for Vader by Luke, and now in episode 9, we have the Vader charred armor catching a blaze once again as it stands up on a figurine or some kind. Now, what I like about that is that that is expert, I believe, you know, parallels that J.J. Abrams was really able to put together and really make it artistic. So, with that being said, I will say that the flash fights, they're sounding very impressive. They really sound like that they are really going to deliver to the Star Wars audience, and I cannot wait to see exactly what they're really going to look like in 3D. You know, I think that's one of the main reasons to see this film in 3D once it arrives is, of course, for the flash fights, because it's said to be heavily inspired by the movie Inception by Christopher Nolan. Anyways, guys, drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about all of this in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.
Night to moon, we hear them moans again, no.